Hello dear children, welcome back. I am Dr. Jisha Jho. In this session, we shall study the structure of kidney tubules and also the blood supply to the kidney tubules. Children, in the last video, we have studied the internal structure of the kidney. We have seen that the kidney has an outer region which is called as the renal cortex and an inner region which is called as the medulla. And the kidney is made up of or composed of millions of microscopic units which are called as the kidney tubules or the nephrons. They are also called as the uriniferous tubules. So we can say that the structural and functional unit of the kidneys is the nephrons. Nephrons are the basic structural and functional units of the kidney. Okay, so in this session, we are going to have a look at the structure of a nephron or a kidney tubule, or otherwise it is also called as the renal tubule or the uriniferous tubule, etc. Now, so the kidney tubule or the nephron comprises of four major parts. The first region is called as the Bowman's capsule. Second is the PCT, which is otherwise called as the proximal convoluted tubule. The third is the loop of Henle, which is a U-shaped loop. Loop of Henle or Henle's loop. And the fourth part is the DCT, which is otherwise called as the distal convoluted tubule. So these are the different parts of a nephron. So we will study in detail about the structure of nephron. So the first region of a kidney tubule is the Bowman's capsule. Bowman's capsule is actually a cup-shaped structure which is formed of a single layer of epithelial cells. You can just imagine a football, one side of which is pushed deep inside. Just imagine a football, the one side of which is pushed inwards. So the Bowman's capsule looks like that. So it is a cup-shaped structure. That is the Bowman's capsule I am going to draw. And it has a hollow internal space. Okay, that is the hollow internal space there. Okay, cup-shaped structure. This cup-shaped structure is called as the Bowman's capsule. And remember, it is formed of the wall of the Bowman's capsule is formed of a single layer of epithelial cells. And internally, it has a hollow space, which is in continuation with the next region of the kidney tubule. The next region of the kidney tubule or the nephron is the PCT. PCT is a region which is it is otherwise called as the proximal convoluted tubule. Okay, so that region is the PCT or the proximal convoluted tubule. Proximal convoluted tubule. So it has several convolutions, and that is why it is called as a convoluted tubule, and it is very close to the Bowman's capsule. It lies very near to the Bowman's capsule, and that is the reason why it is called as the proximal convoluted tubule. It is the part of the renal tubule or the kidney tubule which lies very close to the Bowman's capsule. So that is the second region. Okay, then coming to the third region, which is called as the loop of Henle or the Henle's loop. It is a hairpin shaped like structure. It is a loop. So that is the loop. Okay. Okay. Okay, so that is the Henle's loop. Henle's loop, that is the third region of the kidney tubule, which is a hairpin shaped loop, and the next region, the last region of the nephron, is the DCT. Okay, that is, this region is the DCT, which is otherwise called as the distal convoluted tubule. It is so called because it lies far away from the Bowman's capsule. It is situated far away from the Bowman's capsule. That is why it is called as the distal convoluted tubule. Just like the PCT, it has also convolutions, but it is located far away from the Bowman's capsule, and that is why it is called as the distal convoluted tubule. And the distal convoluted tubule opens into a tube which is called as the collecting duct. A collecting duct receives the DCT of several different nephrons. Okay, so that is the collecting duct. Collecting duct. And these are the ends of the DCT of different nephrons. So this is the structure of a nephron. Once again, the kidney tubule is otherwise called as the nephron or uriniferous tubule, or it is also called as the renal tubule, and the nephron is the basic structural and functional unit of the kidneys. That is, the kidney is formed of or composed of millions of these microscopic tubules called as the nephrons or the kidney tubules. And if you look at the structure of a single nephron, first region of the nephron is a cup-shaped structure, which is called as the Bowman's capsule. And the wall of the Bowman's capsule is formed of a single layer of epithelial cells. Okay, then the hollow internal space of the Bowman's capsule continues with the next region of the renal tubule, which is the proximal convoluted tubule or PCT. It is so called because it lies very close to the Bowman's capsule. The third region of the kidney tubule is the loop of Henle, which is a hairpin shaped loop. And the fourth region is the distal convoluted tubule. This is a part of the nephron which lies far away from the Bowman's capsule. And the distal convoluted tubule opens into the collecting duct. And the collecting duct receives the DCT of several different neurons. And the collecting duct receives the urine that is synthesized from the different DCT or different nephrons and pour this into the pelvis, which is the expanded portion of the ureters. We will study about that later. Now we shall move on to the blood supply to the kidney tubule. Okay, the aorta is the largest artery that carries the oxygenated blood from the heart to the different organs. And the dorsal aorta gives off a branch which is called as the renal artery. The renal artery is the artery that carries blood to the kidney. This blood, which is present in the renal artery, contains all the waste materials that are produced in the different parts of the body. And this, it is this blood that is brought by the renal artery into the kidney. So, the blood vessel that supplies blood to the kidney is the renal artery. Now, once the renal artery enters into the kidney, it divides and redivides to form finer branches, which are called as the arterioles. Okay, and one such arteriole that enters into a Bowman's capsule is called as the efferent arteriole. Okay, the arteriole that enters into the Bowman's capsule is called as the efferent arteriole. So that is the efferent arteriole which I am drawing now. Okay, so how did this efferent arteriole arise? It is formed by the division and the redivision of the renal artery. Renal artery is the artery that supplies blood to the kidney, and the blood that is present in the renal artery contain all the waste materials that are to be excreted out. And from the different parts of the body, these waste materials are collected, and it is the renal artery that carries this blood into the kidney. Once inside the kidney, the renal artery divides and redivides to form finer branches, which are called as the arterioles. We know the arteries divide to form, divide, and the finer branches of the arteries are the arterioles. We have studied that. So, one such arteriole that enters into the Bowman's capsule is called as the efferent arteriole. A, efferent arteriole. Okay, and inside the Bowman's capsule, what happens is that this efferent arteriole breaks up into different capillaries, breaks up to form capillaries, and these capillaries form a knot-like mass inside the Bowman's capsule. Okay. They form a knot-like mass inside the Bowman's capsule. So, the efferent arteriole enters into the Bowman's capsule. In the Bowman's capsule, they divide to form capillaries. These capillaries form a network, or it forms a knot-like mass, K-N-O-T, knot. It forms a network of capillaries inside the concavity of the Bowman's capsule. We can see the network of capillaries there, or it is a knot-like mass of capillaries that are formed inside the concavity of the Bowman's capsule. And what happens, we know these capillaries rejoin and come out of the Bowman's capsule as the efferent arteriole. Efferent arteriole. Okay, so once again, the renal artery is the artery that brings blood to the kidney, and once inside the kidney, the renal artery divides and redivides to form finer branches, which are called as the arterioles. One such arteriole that enters into the concavity of the Bowman's capsule is called as the efferent arteriole. Remember, it is A. Okay, efferent arteriole, it takes in blood. Okay, and once inside the concavity of the Bowman's capsule, the efferent arteriole divides to form capillaries, and these capillaries form a knot-like mass in the concavity of the Bowman's capsule. And this knot-like mass of capillaries in the concavity of the Bowman's capsule is called as glomerulus. Okay, so what is glomerulus? The knot-like mass of capillaries present in the concavity of the Bowman's capsule is called as glomerulus. Now what happens, these capillaries rejoin and or reunite and come out of the Bowman's capsule as the efferent arteriole. It is E, efferent arteriole. That is efferent arteriole, and this is efferent arteriole. Look at the diameter of the two arterioles. So, it is the efferent arteriole that takes in blood into the glomerulus, and it is the efferent arteriole that carries blood out. Okay, and just look at the diameter of the two arterioles. You can see that the efferent arteriole is wider than the efferent arteriole. Okay, this is necessary for the better functioning of the kidney tubule. This particular difference, or this difference in the diameter of the two arterioles, is necessary for the proper functioning of the kidney tubules, which we will study in the next class. So, the afferent arteriole has a wider diameter, or it has more diameter or a greater diameter than the efferent arteriole. We have seen glomerulus is the knot-like mass of capillaries that are present in the concavity of the Bowman's capsule. So, this glomerulus together with the Bowman's capsule is termed as the Malpighian capsule. Okay, Malpighian. Malpighian capsule. Pronounce it as Malpighian, not Malpighian. If you pronounce it as Malpighian, you will get the spelling wrong. It is Malpighian. Malpighian. Malpighian capsule. So, what is Malpighian capsule? The Bowman's capsule together with the glomerulus. That means this much. Okay, this much is the Malpighian capsule. Okay, now as we have seen in the previous session or previous video that the cortex has a dotted appearance. What is the reason for this dotted appearance of the renal cortex? It is due to the presence of these glomerulus. The glomerulus along with the Bowman's capsule, PCT and DCT are present in the renal cortex, and the dotted appearance of the renal cortex is due to the presence of this knot-like mass of capillaries, that is glomerulus, in the renal cortex. So, I hope that is clear to you. Can be asked is give reason the renal cortex has a dotted appearance. So, it is in the renal cortex, the Bowman's capsule along with the glomerulus, PCT and DCT are present. The knot-like mass of capillaries of the glomerulus give that dotted appearance to the renal cortex. Now, as we have also mentioned that in the renal medulla has a striped appearance. What are the parts of the nephron that lies in the renal medulla? The Henle's loop and the collecting duct. So, it is the presence of the Henle's loop and the collecting duct in the renal medulla that gives the striped appearance to the renal medulla. So, these are two give reasons that you can expect from this part. We will continue with the blood supply. So, it is the renal artery that supplies blood to the kidney. Inside the kidney, the renal artery breaks off into branches which are called as the arterioles. One such arteriole that enters into the Bowman's capsule is called as the afferent arteriole. In the concavity of the Bowman's capsule, the afferent arteriole breaks up into capillaries. These capillaries form a knot-like mass inside the concavity of the Bowman's capsule. This knot-like mass of capillaries is called as the glomerulus, and the capillaries reunite and come out of the Bowman's capsule as the efferent arteriole. So, we have seen that much. Now, the efferent arteriole runs for some distance and then they break up into capillaries. They break up into capillaries. You can see See, which I have marked in red line, they are the capillaries. This network of capillaries is called as the secondary capillary network or vasa recta. Okay, vasa recta or the secondary capillary network. That is, after the efferent arteriole comes out of the Bowman's capsule, runs for a short distance and then breaks up into a network of capillaries, which we call as the secondary capillary network or the vasa recta. So, okay, so that is the network of capillaries that you can see there surrounding the tubular region of the nephron. Okay, so how is it formed? By that is from the efferent arteriole. That is, efferent arteriole comes out of the Bowman's capsule, run for a short distance, and after which it branches off to form capillaries. These network of capillaries is called as the secondary capillary network, or it is otherwise called as the vasa recta. And finally, what happens to the secondary capillary network? These capillaries rejoin and come out of the nephron as a vein. Okay, these capillaries rejoin. You can see these are all different capillaries which rejoin and come out as a single vein. That is, a single vein that is coming out of the nephron. And similarly, from different nephrons, such veins come out. Okay, and these veins later on rejoin and come out of the kidney as the renal vein. So, the blood vessel that carries blood away from the kidney is the renal vein. So, it is the secondary capillary network or the vasa recta. The capillaries of the vasa recta join and come out of each nephron as a vein. And these veins which come out from different nephrons rejoin and come out of the kidney as the renal vein. So, the blood vessel that carries blood to the kidney is the renal artery. Remember, this blood is rich in oxygen, but it has all the nitrogenous waste, all the waste materials, excess salts, etc. that are to be removed out is also present in this blood that is present in the renal artery. Okay, whereas the blood that leaves the kidney, the blood vessel that carries blood away from the kidney is the renal vein. Remember, this blood that is present in the renal vein has more amount of carbon dioxide and it has a less amount of waste materials, or almost all the waste materials have been absorbed by the or have been removed by the kidney. And if we say the clean blood, it is the clean blood which is devoid of all the waste which comes out of the kidney through the renal vein, but it is deoxygenated blood. Okay, and this blood which is carried by the renal vein is drained or poured into the posterior vena cava, which carries the blood into the heart. So, that is how the blood supply takes place in the kidney tubule. So, my dear children, I hope this session is clear to you. In this session, we have studied the structure of a kidney tubule and the blood supply to the kidney tubule. So if you have any doubts regarding what we have studied today, please ask your doubts and also give your suggestions in the comment section. Thank you.